This video is going to be about finding the area and circumference of parts of circles. So, just as we did with rectangles and triangles, we're going to look at figures that have circular elements and use the rules we know about circles to figure out more complicated problems. So, let's say we're given this figure, like a donut, and we're told to find the red area. Okay? So, first of all, let's remember what we know about the area of a circle. So, the area of a circle is equal to the number pi times the radius squared. Now, using this formula and thinking this problem through, we can find the red area. What we have here is two circles. We have a big circle, and we have a small circle inside it. And the red area is going to be the area of the big circle with the small circle taken away from it. So now all we have to do is find the area for each of the circles, the big circle and the small circle, and we'll be able to solve the problem. So let's start with the small circle. The small circle has a diameter of 2, which means that its radius is 1. Remember that the radius is the distance from the center of a circle to the edge, and the diameter is the distance all the way through. So if we divide the diameter in half, we'll get the radius. So for the small circle, the area of the small circle, we're going to get pi times the radius squared. Well, the radius squared is 1 squared, which is really just the same as pi times 1 squared. 1 squared is 1. So this area in here, this white area, is just going to be pi. Let's see about the area for the big circle. Okay, what we need is the radius for the big circle. We know that the distance from here to here is 2, and if we want to go to the center, it means we have to go from here to the center, and that would be the radius of the small circle. So the distance from the edge of the big circle to the very center is going to be 2 plus 1, or 3. So the area for that circle, the whole big circle, is going to be pi times 3 squared. 3 squared is 9, so that's going to be 9 pi. And the area for the red circle, so they're just the red area, is going to be 9 pi minus pi. So 9 pi, we can think of this as 1 pi. 9 pi minus 1 pi is 8 pi. And you could leave the answer like this, or you could use the pi button in your calculator and multiply by 8, or you could use the approximate number for pi, so it would be 8 times 3.14, and then we would multiply this out and get an answer. Actually, let's do that. So 8 times 4 is 32. We're going to carry a 3. 8 times 1 is 8, plus 3 is 11. So I've got a 1, my decimal point. I've got to carry a 1. 8 times 3 is 24, plus 1 is 25. So my approximate area would be 25.12 square units. Okay? Let's look at a different problem. Let's say we've got this shape. We've got a square angle at each of the bottom angles. We've got a base here, which is 8. Looks like it goes up 3 units. And then we've got this half a circle on top of it. And let's see if we can find the area. So what we want to do is think of this as the sum of its parts. And its parts are going to be this rectangle and this half circle. Okay, so the area for the rectangle the area for the rectangle should be pretty easy to find. I'm just going to multiply the length times the width. And the length times the width will be the same as 8 times 3. So the area for the rectangle is 24 square units. That's this area here. Now I want the area for, that looks like a triangle. I want the area for that semicircle, the half circle. Well, I know the formula for the area of a circle. That's area equals pi r squared. So what I'm going to do is think, okay, if this was a circle, what would its area be? And then I'll divide that amount by 2. I'll divide it in half to find out what the area of half of that is. So let's see. I need to find the radius. If this was a circle, this distance here would be the diameter. So half of the diameter is the radius, and that would be 4. So the area of the whole circle would be pi times 4 squared, but I only want half of that, so I'll divide it by 2. So let's see, that's going to give me 4 squared is 16, and 16 divided by 2 is 8, so that's going to give me 8 pi, and then what I want to do is add together the area for the rectangle and the area for the half circle. So the rectangle was 24 plus 8 pi. And I can leave it like that. I could put this in the calculator and use the pi button. Or I could multiply 8 times 3.14 and then add that to 24. Okay, but what I want to do is go on to the perimeter before I run out of time. So the perimeter here, so let's look at this. Well, the perimeter is going to be the distance all the way around. I've got this side, I've got this side. This side would be 3. So what I want is this distance, which is 1/2 of the circumference of a whole circle. So the circumference of this circle would be pi times the diameter. The diameter is 8. So the circumference for the whole circle would be 8 times pi, but I only want half of that. I want the circumference for the half circle. So I'll divide it by 2, and I'll get 4 pi. So this distance over here is 4 pi. And now all I've got to do to find the perimeter around this figure will be to add these numbers. Let's start over here. So I'm going to have the perimeter is going to equal 3 plus 8 plus 3. 3 plus 8 plus 3 plus this distance halfway around the circular part. And now I'll add these together. So 3 plus 8 is 11 plus 3 is 14. Plus 4 pi. And once again, I can put this into my calculator, or I can multiply 4 times the approximate value of pi, 3.14, and then add 14 to it. Okay, so I hope you get the picture. That's about it for now, I guess. Take care. See you next time.